Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to render in wireframe. There is three ways that I know how to do this. There might be more, but I'm going to be showing you the three ways that I know how to render in wireframe. Alright, I'm going to bring this tab out so we can see everything over here. First, I'm just going to create like a basic scene, so I'm going to delete this cube and then press Shift A, add in a plane. We'll scale this plane up to like, let's say 8, so it fits the grid size, and then I'm going to add in, let's say like a... What should we add in? Let's do a monkey head because I think that will be the best. So let's go into side view by pressing 3 on the number pad, then go into orthographic view, and we'll just rotate this up, place it right on top of our plane, somewhere around here. Okay, just kind of lining it up. Okay, there we go. So now we have this, and if we go into camera view, we can see our monkey head. So let's just grab our camera and zoom in a little bit so we can see it a little bit closer. We'll position the camera right about there. That looks pretty good to me. Okay, so now what we can do is right click on this, and I'll show you a couple of ways to render in wireframe. The first one I'm going to be showing you is the modifier wireframe. So let's add in a subdivision surface so we can smooth out this. We'll set the view and the render to 2, and then we'll click smooth shading over here. I'm going to close this by pressing T so we have some more space. Okay, so now let's click add modifier, and if we come down to wireframe, we can see our wireframe right there. What I'm going to do is just duplicate this by hitting Shift D, so there's 2 in the place. Actually, we don't need to do that. We can right click on this, add in the wireframe, and then uncheck replace original. So there, our original will still stay right there. So now we can zoom in here and we can see that the lines are crazy thick. So this right here determines how thick it will be. Usually you would set this to a very low number, let's say 0.3, something really, really small. That might be a little bit too small. Let's go 0.5, something like that looks pretty good. Okay, and then you would check this right here, make sure it's set to 1, then come over here, click new, we'll just name this like white, we'll leave it as the diffuse, we'll add in a new material, we'll go new, we'll change this one to black, and then just change this to black. And so now this, since we set it to 1, we'll grab the black material and replace that for the wireframe. So if I press Shift Z, we can see the wireframe. Just give it a second to render. There we go, our wireframe is there. So that looks pretty good. Let's do a quick render. So let's go over to here. We'll just change the performance to 256 on both of these and set the sampling really low so it will render pretty faster. Let's go with 8 samples. Then I will click render. So this will take about like just a couple seconds, and there we can see our wireframe pop up. Nice. Now this is a little bit slow. Since there is more geometry on your mesh, it might slow your computer down, so there is a better way, and I'll show you that in a little bit. But there we can see our wireframe, and it looks okay. I think the thickness should come up just a little bit. But that is how you render with the modifier. Now I'm going to delete this. I'm going to go into the node editor and do some stuff over here. So I'm in the node editor, and right now I'm going to grab our white material. I'm just going to get rid of this black one since we're not going to need it anymore, and play around with this white one. So there is a node called wireframe, and if I remember where it's at, it's under input and then wireframe right here. So to use this, I'm going to add in a mix right here, color mix. I'm going to take this color output, plug it into here, then I'm going to take this factor output, plug it into the factor, and now this color right here determines what this wireframe will look like. So if I set this to something crazy like a blue color and we press Shift Z, we can see that the wireframe is now blue. But the bad thing about using this one is that all of the faces are like triangular, and I don't know why. I'm not sure how to fix this. I think this is just how it works. And you can change the thickness right here, so we can go with something a little bit lower, like 0.5. So the wires are a little bit less visible. Then of course we can change this to a black color. So if you want your wireframe to be triangle, go ahead and use this one, but I'll show you the best way that I found out how to use or how to render wireframe, and I'll show you that in a little bit. This pixel size, what this will do, if you turn it on, it will display the size of the wireframe determining how big your computer screen. See, it says use screen pixel size instead of world units. So if I uncheck that, it's going to be using the Blender world units. If I check this on, then it's going to be using my screen to determine the size. So it would have to go up to maybe, let's just go 1 pixel, and you can see it's right there. So usually I just like to turn that off and then just set it to like 0.002. Is that what I set it at? I'm just gonna leave it right there. That's pretty cool. And then of course this one determines the color of just the main model. So I can bring that up and we can have a white model with a triangle black wireframe. Nice. And then we can go ahead and render this. So I'm gonna go into shift. I'm gonna press shift F and F10. And that will bring us to our render layer. I'm going to change the slot to slot 2. Then I'm going to press F12, and this will render out. And there we go. We can see our wireframe. And this renders a little bit faster since it's just in the material and there's no more geometry. Nice. So I'm going to get rid of all of these and just leave the diffuse right there. I'm going to close this. And now the last way I'm going to be showing you how to render in wireframe. Okay, so if we come over to the render settings and we come down here to Freestyle, what Freestyle does is it just draws a couple lines where your geometry is. So I'm just going to turn that on and I'll hit render. I'm going to go into right here, go to slot 3 and click render. And once this is done, once it's done rendering, it will do like this composition. You know how when you're in the compositor and it overlays on top? That's what it's gonna do. So once it's done rendering, it's going to overlay some like black streaks on our mesh. And you can see it right there. We go. We can see like these, it's kind of like a cartoonish outline sort of thing. So we can play around with this, and that's what it does right there. But if we go over to the render layer panels, there's a couple different options under Freestyle. There's things over here. We can use edge mark, and what this will do is if we go into edit mode, press Control E and go mark Freestyle edge, that will turn everything into this like green yellowish color. And then we check this. Now once we render, it's gonna render a black line on every single one of those lines. So that is pretty cool, and I'll show you what these options do. But let's do a quick render. So let's go back to the UV image editor, go to slot 4 and click render. Now this will go, we'll just give it a couple seconds and you can see what it looks like. And once it's done, it will do the stroke rendering, and there we go, we can see our wireframe. And that looks a lot better than the ones over here. I'll just press J to go through them. So this is the first one where it's kind of hard to see. This is the second one. This is the Freestyle. And I think this one looks a lot better. And there's still more stuff that we could do to make it look even better than it already is. So if we come down here, we can make sure that's on. Now there's a couple different options here. First off, we can change the color. So we can set it to a blue color or something like that. So I'm just gonna go with a light blue. You can set an alpha, so the lower you turn this down, the more transparent it will be. I'm just gonna go with like 0.8 just to demonstrate. Now the thickness, this is pretty cool. This will determine the thickness of the stroke. So if we want wireframe, we can go with 1.5 probably. That's probably a good number. This, I'm not sure exactly what this is for. I tried adding a texture and I couldn't really figure that out. So if you guys know what this texture thing is for, or this geometry, please let me know. I would love to hear it. Okay, so then let's go back over here, and you can change some settings down here as well. So if we turn this on, we can set a dash. Let me just bring out this so you can see it a little bit more. We can see dash 1 and the gap. So if I turn the dash to, let's say, 15 pixels, the gap to 15, it's going to be like a dashed line instead of a straight line. So let's go over here and click render. Let's go to a new slot so we can look back, slot 5, and click render. And the render is done, and there we can see our dotted line. Now that looks pretty cool. We can see the gap between them, and I like that. So that's pretty cool. We can go back and we can also see the line on our plane up there, so that is cool as well. So let's go back to the 3D view and let's check the settings. I'm gonna turn off the gap because I want this just to be wireframe, so 0, 0. You can also just uncheck that and that will fix it. Now let's see here. I haven't played around with these options very much. I've just done the color and the alpha and the thickness. So I'm going to change the color back to a black color all the way down. There we go. And the thickness is, let's just go with a little bit thinner. Let's go 0.02. That looks pretty good. Okay, so I think everything's good. We'll do one more render. So let's just click render right here and it will render out. And there we can see our wireframe one more time. I forgot to switch the layer down there, so it's on slot 5 again. So that will give it just a couple seconds. And 96, 100%. You can see that stroke rendering is up there. And there we go, we can see it. It's a little bit thin, so it's a little bit hard to see. But there we can see it, our wireframe, and that looks really nice. So that is how you render in render wireframe in Blender. We'll go through them one more time. So you can got the modifier, which is right here. You have the material, which is this one right here. It's got triangle faces. And then you have the freestyle, which is all of these. And then this one finally. So make sure this is turned on. You can also turn the line thickness right here as well. But that is how you render in wireframe. Thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed, make sure to comment down below. If you made a cool render with this, I would love to see it. So you can tweet it to me at Blender Made Easy, or you can send it to my Instagram. Same thing, Blender Made Easy. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial.